quintessential Burrow. I sent a clip of Joe back at LSU to Coach Jimmy yesterday. I sent him the clip that you guys sent me on TikTok of Joe leading the leading the practice and going to Michael Divinity before it started, talking about Divinity and how LSU's offense was going to get Divinity and that defense, they were going to get a part of their ass that day at practice, and it was great Burrow stuff. And then you turn on ESPN and you see him working alongside Ja'Marr Chase with a couple of Cincinnati Bengals helmets on. Coach Jimmy Burrow is here with us this morning to talk a little football, and it's always great to catch up. Good morning, Coach. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks for having me, guys.
Always. How is the man? Because when you talk about he could miss this summer. He didn't have to be there. He didn't have to be out there. I would imagine that somebody in the franchise is like, look, Joe, if you don't want to go, buddy, you don't have to do this. His mindset, Coach, of just getting back to a state where he can get on the field and go through summer workouts. What have you seen from your point of view on him?
Well, it's just a lot of it goes back to how competitive he is and how committed he is really to his teammates. And that was a goal, to push as hard as he could and without going too fast, and kind of take it day by day, week by week, and things just started to progress to the point that he was able to be there and throw. And he'd been throwing for several weeks, but really just a stationary target, and was having success doing it as far as his knee feeling good. So, they worked up a plan, and there he is out there, like you see, throwing to Ja'Marr and all the other receivers. And it's just, a credit to not only the Dr. Elitrosh, who did the surgery, but the Bengals training and rehabilitation staff. But Nick Cosgrove is the leader at that, and they've just done a great job getting him back to at least where he is now.
Coach, I heard a podcast with Chris Collinsworth sitting down with Joe, and one of the parts that came up that was real interesting was the relationship that he has with Zach Taylor. I know I've asked you about Taylor in some of our chats and conversations, but it seems like Joe was able to develop a great rapport and relationship with Taylor going into his first year. This was even before he had taken a snap at the professional level. Can you talk about how that relationship has developed now that Joe's been in the system for a year, and it looks like and sounds like those guys have really the ultimate trust in one another?
Yeah, that's true. He really has developed a great relationship with Zach, and also the other offensive coaches. And it's kind of tough because, other than a few minutes at the combine that year, there really wasn't any meetings with Zach. But I had known Zach somewhat from Nebraska, and he had coached with the University of Cincinnati, and we had visited over there a few times. So, but once they got together and they started with their Zoom meetings during the pandemic, I think Joe was just impressed that, they were always willing to look back at LSU film and take things that worked for Joe and that Joe liked and kind of put it in their offensive playbook. And I think anytime that happens, the relationship starts out really good. So, it's a spread offense, which Joe loves. And as I said, there's a lot of similarities to some of the things they did at LSU. And then, on game day, he trusts Zach with the play calling. And that was starting to really get better and better before Joe got hurt. And so really it's just a trust factor, and that relationship hopefully will continue.
One thing that I imagine that he is very excited about adding to the Cincinnati playbook that he had at the LSU playbook is Ja'Marr Chase. maybe the best player on offense outside of him. That chemistry looks like it's picked up right where it left off in 19, Coach.
Yeah, it was, awesome to to be able to, for the Bengals to draft Jamar. I know Joe's knows he's a great player, and they were also really good friends, as were many of those guys on that LSU football team. They still continue to talk wherever Justin Jefferson is, or Clyde, or a lot of those guys. So just to get another guy that Joe felt comfortable with, not only as a person and friend, but certainly a great football player. And we had gotten to know Jimmy Chase and Jamar's mother, and so that was big for us. We communicated. We've been to Cincinnati and had brunch with them. And you know, there's, when you come from New Orleans to Cincinnati, it's quite a change, and they had a lot of questions, and even as we did last year, as far as you know, where do you go for this, or how do we do this, and so, you know, we had a relationship before, and we're looking forward to the tailgate if they let us back in this year, which I think they're going to. But, you know, getting Jamar is huge, certainly.
Coach, we've seen Joe make a leap from year one to year two, like we did at LSU. I'm wondering, and he's obviously going to his second year with the Bengals. Did he say anything from 2018 to 2019 to you, like, Coach, we could be special here? And does he have any similar feelings about where the Bengals are?
In the spring of that year, he did. He said, "No, I think we do have a chance to be really, really good." And my question was, you know, what makes you think that? And he says, you know, we're going against a great defense and one of the best defense as far as personnel, and they can't stop us. So that in his mind, you know, indicated that they would be able to do that against a lot of people, and so he thought they could be special. And I think with the Bengals, he thinks it's certainly a work in progress, but the pieces are starting to fall in place, that they're going to be dynamic on offense with T. Higgins and Tyler Boyd and Jamar and Joe Mixon at running back. So in his mind, you know, the future looks great, I think he thinks that down the road they can be special, but certainly a lot of hard work still needs to take place.
From your coaching experience, and you've been around it more than 40 years, this is a question about your son, but if you can you answer it as a coach? What is the ceiling on his mental capacity as a football player? I mean, I'm just watching people diagnose and talk about what he says and what he sees, and it's almost like they're talking about a football savant or one of these generational type players. And in your opinion, in your mindset, were there landmarks or mile markers along the way where you kind of got back to the house and said, "Damn, I didn't even think of that." Yeah, right. I mean, he's really, really smart. What is the? I guess just the initial question. What, from your point of view, is his ceiling in mental capacity around the game of football, and how smart is he?
Well, he has a great memory of things that have happened to him on the football field in the past, and I think you know, having the experience to make sure that things like that have maybe happened bad, like an interception, he remembers why and how not to do that again, and it kind of leads into him being able to not make the same mistake twice. And I'm a defensive coordinator, I'm watching him, and he's always throwing to the open receiver, and you say, well, that's what they're supposed to be, but it's not that easy to find the open receiver every time. But if you're trying to defend him and changing up the coverage, and he seems to always have a great feel for that. He understands coverages and he understands pass protection also. So it just adds up to, you know, what you're looking for in a quarterback. And he's always studied the game and had great preparation, but really, again, just his knowledge of the game and his memory of things that he watches on film, and the memory of the games and the experiences in those games, he really draws on that in the future game.
Looks like he's working on his deep ball this offseason and throwing the deep ball. What have you seen? It seems like this is something that he's intently working on.
Well, he's always been a great deep ball thrower. High school, even at Ohio State, and then at LSU, certainly, especially 2019. And they weren't able to connect last year. And who knows the reasons, but he takes something every year that he really wants to get better at. And that's something individually he wants to get better at. And Zach Taylor has mentioned that as a team, they really want to be able to have more explosive plays and throw deep. And I think Jamar will help. And T. Higgins coming back for his second year, and Tyler Boyd, those guys, they'll be able to get downfield this year. And I think Joe, having the mindset that he's going to be better at it, and they're going to be better at it as a team, will play out in the future. But yeah, they're working on it. I mean, his arm is stronger. He's developed a little more velocity on the ball. And when you're a rookie quarterback, not everything clicks as easily as you would like, especially with really no OTAs or mini camps or anything like that last year. So, you know, when he got hurt, it was still a work in progress. I think they would have gotten better at the deep ball if he hadn't got hurt. But something that they have to get better at. I think he understands that and wants to really get back to being able to throw deep to those guys.
Burrow's summer vacation planned? And does the Golden Boy make it, or do you guys not see him for the next 20 years on a summer vacation?
He's got my own money, cuz.
Yeah, right. Yeah, we're always, we've gone down to Florida for many years with different places between Destin and Panama City. And we'll continue to do that this year. And when I ask him about things like that, we have a 4th of July get together planned, and he just says it's a game time decision. So that means he might the day before say, "Hey, I'll see you in Florida," or he might say, "I can't go," or he might in the middle of the vacation call and say he's on his way. So game time decision. But we've done it for so long, and certainly when he was growing up and in high school, he was with us every summer, and Jamie and Dan are always there, but he hasn't been for two or three summers now. So we're hopefully that game time decision will be a go, and he'll be there.
Well, it's always great to catch up with you, Coach. Send our best to Miss Robin and the crew, Danny and the boys, and of course to Joey. As you guys have a great summer, we'll catch up soon.
All right, thanks for having me. I listened to your interview of the young lady Moon, the basketball, and that was great. I'm looking forward to following that women's basketball team too.
Kim Mulkey was a great hire down here in Baton Rouge, Coach. I mean, everybody has really responded to bringing her aboard.
Yes, and I mentioned my dad was a women's basketball coach after he played at Mississippi State, and I grew up on the bench with my dad doing that, and my mom was a legendary player, so I'll be following and rooting. Give me another sport to root for the Tigers.
We'll talk soon, Coach. Thank you.
All right, thanks a lot.
All right, there he is, the man, Coach Jimmy Burrow, checking in this morning here.